Thelema, Coast to Coast, Show 28, June 24th, 2006. Do what thou wilt shall be the whole of the law. Welcome to Thelema Coast to Coast. My name is John Crow, and I'm the host of the show. Before getting started, I want to remind everybody the four ways to get in touch with the podcast. First is via email, podcast@thelemacoasttocoast.com, the website, thelemacoasttocoast.com. The voicemail is area code 206-600-4216, and via U.S. mail, Thelema Coast to Coast, care of John Crow, P.O. Box 7045, Marietta, Georgia, M-A-R-I-E-T-T-A, 30065. And that's in the U.S. On today's show, I'm going to be having a 20-minute interview with Keith about the Thelemic conversion process and things we've noticed in the Thelemic community. Also, I have an interview with Sam Webster. He is the founder of the open source Golden Dawn. But before getting into that, I want to talk about a few of the other things that are Thelema Coast to Coast related. Also go over listener email and voicemail and give away a LaTeX record CD. First, as I've mentioned in the past, there is a MySpace page for Thelema Coast to Coast, and over 500 people have friended it. So if you have a MySpace page and want to go over to it, go to www.myspace.com/ThelemaCoastToCoast and make a friends request, and I'll be happy to add you to the friends list. Also, Thelema Coast to Coast has a Frapper map that can be seen on the front page of the Thelema Coast to Coast website. I want to thank the 230 people who have already signed up for the Frapper map. We have listeners all over the U.S., Canada, Europe, Australia, and other places. I noticed some of the listeners in Asia have not signed up on the Frapper map. So if you're out there, listeners, please take a moment and go to the Frapper map and list your location too. Now, I've been looking at some of the stats of the website since the beginning of the year, and I want to thank all the listeners. The website has had well over 1 million hits since January 1. And I specifically want to thank those who use the Thelema Coast to Coast banners on their website, their blogs, the profile pages, signatures, and so forth. I can really see the traffic generated from those. And if you have a blog or a website that you want to put the Thelema Coast to Coast banner on, please just go to the Thelema Coast to Coast website. There's a link on the right-hand side that gives you instructions and the code and everything to link directly to the banner. The banner is hosted on my website, so the traffic comes from my server. Please get the word out. Okay, also I want to thank the people who have been spreading the word about Thelema Coast to Coast and talking about it in their blogs. If you Google the phrase Thelema Coast to Coast, the whole phrase, it comes up over 12,000 times in Google. So clearly the word about the website and the show is getting out, and I appreciate that. As I mentioned, the last two shows, on June 6th, I had a meetup in Berkeley, California at Jupiter, and about a dozen people came, and I really appreciated it. Met a whole bunch of listeners and put some faces with names. Also had a number of the guests that have been on the show at the meetup. Keith418 was there, Jerry Cornelius, Eric Kaushin from the Temple of Set. There are pictures from the meetup. They are on the Thelema Coast to Coast website in the forum, so if you want to check that out, feel free to go to the Thelema Coast to Coast website and go into the forum. Next, I want to go into listener email and voicemail. The first one is from a listener named Lisa. She writes, "Hi, John. The Lima Coast to Coast is wonderful. I have really enjoyed listening to it. I discovered your show last week, and now I've listened to the first 23. As a tarot reader, I rely heavily on the systems, correspondences, and attributions that come out of the Golden Dawn and went into creating the occult tarot deck. Since I'm not part of a magical order, it has been insightful to hear people who are discuss their viewpoints. You also inspired me to looking into the English Kabbalah. Last weekend, I created a MySQL database and some PHP pages to calculate and compare systems." I'll have the link to that in the show notes. And she has a webpage that has a number of Kabbalahs on it that have to do with Nubian English Kabbalah and other Kabbalistic systems. When you enter a word, it gives you the Kabbalistic value of words similar to it in the various systems. So thank you very much, Lisa. I appreciate the email and the interest in Nubian English Kabbalah. Next is a voicemail from a listener in the UK.
Hi, John. This is Alex calling from England. Just want to leave you a quick voicemail to let you know how much I thoroughly enjoy the show. Love the interviews. Always look forward to interviews with Keith 418. Also, wanted to mention that I saw on Bishop Greenfield's website that it looks like he's left the OTO, or at least the OTO management. Wasn't sure if there's going to be any coverage of that in the show, but it certainly looks quite interesting, as his reasons for leaving seem to echo certain things that have already been said on the show. So, yeah, I thought that was very interesting. Hope the shows carry on. Hope you had a fantastic time at the meet in California. Obviously wasn't able to get there, but I hope you all had a wonderful time. And I look forward to the next podcast. Keep up the great work. Bye.
Thanks for that voicemail. I understand your interest in Alan's statement. I am well aware of it. Alan currently is in the process of moving and getting settled, so I will not be interviewing him about it in the next month or so, but it definitely has been something I've talked to him about, and we will be having him on the show about this in the near future, probably by the end of the summer. So thanks for the comments. Next is an email from a listener named Rick. 93 John, I just wanted to know if there were any tips for the solitary practitioner. I see certain advantages to the notion of a group will, but many local thelemic bodies seem sporadic in their activities. Also, I've gotten the idea from various interviews with Keith 418 that he seems to think most groups, and hence most practitioners, are, well, posers. That people would rather wear cool robes and chant cool things and discuss cool stuff and in general be, well, cool. He's quite interesting, and I'm glad you feature him frequently, although I'm sure he pisses many people off with his blunt criticisms of the organization. I'm also glad you included his Nietzsche lecture on the podcast. He should do more of them. I had always figured there was a Nietzsche-Thelemic link, as both Nietzsche and Crowley seem to have a view vaguely aristocratic, but not an aristocracy of birth, rather of ability and inner dedication. Nietzsche definitely held that view, and the impression I got from Lawrence Sutton's biography of Crowley was quite similar. I have no idea where this egalitarian thelema has its roots. Even in the Book of the Law, you don't really see that. Even if every man and woman is a star, it doesn't follow that every man and every woman are equal in ability or desire. Also, if Keith has a website, please let me know. Or if he has some books, I quite enjoy his outspokenness. 93s. Well, Rick, Keith does have a website. It is his blog, but he's pretty exclusive on who goes to it. It is on LiveJournal, so if you go to livejournal.com/Keith418, you will find it. However, you need to have a LiveJournal account and then friend it, and depending on if your LiveJournal is interesting, he might friend you back. He is very elitist about the whole idea, and if you're not interesting to read, he doesn't feel that you necessarily need to be reading his LJ. And I'm sure if I've got that wrong, he will correct me. So you can go check that out. He doesn't have any books out at this time. Also, there clearly is a Nietzsche-Crowley connection. Crowley quotes Nietzsche quite frequently. It would seem that you haven't read that much Crowley, because if you have, you would see that quite quickly. So I encourage you to go out and read his Magic Without Tears, Book 4, and the commentaries to Liber Aleph, etc. Now, regarding your question about the solitary practitioner and the dysfunction of the local thelemic bodies, I would have to disagree with you about the impression that Keith gives about the community. He does not give the idea that being a solitary practitioner is good because the local communities are messed up. He's saying that to really be an individual, you have to be in a community. Now, that may sound odd, but let me quote from a book called The Triumph of the Therapeutic by Philip Reif. From Plato to Aristotle, through Burke and de Tocqueville, the therapeutic implication of social theory is remarkably consistent. An individual can exercise his gifts and powers fully only by participating in the common life. This is the classical ideal. The healthy man is, in fact, the good citizen. So, if you really want to be a good practitioner, if you really want to be involved in your magic and be an individual, you need to be involved in a community. Now, that does not mean any particular organization. If you find that the OTO is not to your liking and that there are other organizations, that's great. Or even if it's just a loose group of friends or acquaintances that you do magic with, that's fine. But it's hard to do this kind of work by yourself. You certainly want to be very, very picky about who you do the magical work with. You just don't want to get with any group of idiots and start doing magic, especially if you're doing any kind of high magic. You never know what kind of circumstances will occur, and if you have somebody who doesn't know what they're doing in that environment, it can cause quite a problem. So you want to be very exclusive on who you work with, test them, ask questions, and so forth. But it's really going to be hard to do this kind of stuff by yourself. So I think you should start looking for a group to work with. If there's no organization around you, start putting ads out and start looking for like-minded people and build your own group. It certainly is a viable option, and it is something that really needs to be done if we want to move forward in our magical practices. So thanks for writing, Rick. Okay, the next voicemail is from a listener in her car.
Hi, John. This is Ella Faith in Santa Clara. I wanted to call in and let you know how I listen to the podcast, because I listen in my car, as you can probably tell by the background noise, and I suspect that by the time I get to a computer, to go to the site and enter the poll, I will forget. So I download the podcast using Juice, so it downloads automatically. I almost never actually remember to go to the site. And then I load it onto my Neuros MP3 player, which is infinitely superior to all the iPods people are using, and I listen to it in my car using an FM transmitter. So that's how I listen. Keep up the great work.
Thanks for the voicemail. I appreciate that. And thanks for the reminder. I am doing a poll about how people listen to the podcast. The podcatcher I see mostly in the stats is iTunes, so I appreciate you letting me know that you use Juice as your podcatcher. And if people could go to the Thelema Coast to Coast website and fill out the poll in the top left corner, I'd appreciate it, because it lets me know how the podcast is being delivered. Okay, so as in previous shows, I have been giving CDs away from Latex Records. Kind of took a bit of a hiatus the last month or so on that, so I wanted to get back into it. A few shows ago, I played a song from Little Tin Box. The CD is called Action Music, and that CD is being given away to Richard in Charlotte, North Carolina. So thanks for entering, Richard. I will have this CD off to you in a few weeks. Also, at the end of the show, we will be playing another Latex Records album called Written in Ashes, and the song from that will be called Unfaith. Okay, well, that's the opening remarks from me. Today it wasn't too long, which is good. So let's get into the interview with Keith 418, and we will be discussing about the thelemic conversion process.
Keith, welcome back to the podcast, 93.
93, John. Thanks for having me.
In a previous podcast, you talked about or used the term crisis of conversion. What is this crisis of conversion?
Well, I think it's interesting to look at in a Thelema context, because it's something sociologists in the history of religion people tend to look at when they study religion, is the conversion crisis. Most of the people in the OTO were not raised in a Thelemic family. I think that that's fairly rare. Most of us were raised in families of other faiths or no faiths at all.